Good morning, students. Today we are going to see about cross multiplication method. Okay, so already we have completed substitution method and elimination method. This is exercise 3.13 cross multiplication method. Okay, so how to do this method means for this method also we are going to take only the coefficients of the variables x and y or a, b, c, anything. Okay. What variable is given, you can choose the coefficients and constant term also. Okay, for example, the linear equation is in the form of ax1 plus by1 plus c1 equal to 0. Okay, in this method, the equation must be the left right hand side must be 0. Okay, wow. The constant also you should take it left side. Then another equation, you can take it as a1 b1, okay, a1 b1 c1. Then x1 a2 x2, sorry, a1 x plus b1 y plus c1 equal to 0, and another equation a2 x plus b2 y plus c2 is equal to 0. Okay, this is the form of the equation. If you have any constant term in the right hand side, that also you should take it in the left hand side. In this method, the right hand side must be 0. Okay, after that, what we have to do, you have to take it the variables, that is x and y and the constant one. Okay, well, so you should start from this b1 b2. Okay, wow. So enna pannanum b1 b2 la irundhu start pannanum b1 b2, then another c1 c2, then next again a1 a2, then again b1 b2. Okay, edhula start pandromo adhiley mudikanum. So b1 b2 la start pannuvinge, then you are finishing with b1 b2. Okay, then next one you can do it the cross multiplication. For that only we are called this method is a cross multiplication. First down arrow, okay, so you can take it as x divided by, here what is that, b1 and c2. If you multiply, you will get b1 c2 minus that upward arrow b2 c1, that is equal to then y. Okay, y is divided by then another constants. Okay, c1 and a2. If you multiply, you will get c1 a2 then minus c2 a1. Okay, then next term 1 divided by a1 b2 then minus a2 b1. Okay, so in the format la namba ezhudikitta numbers ah enna pannikalam multiply pannite, then next we can compare the x term and the constant term, then y term and the constant term. Okay, x divided by b1 c2 then minus b2 c1. இப்ப என்ன பண்ணிக்கணும், x டம்ஸையும் constant டம்ஸையும் கம்பேர் பண்ணி x வேல்யூ ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். Then y வேல்யூவையும் constant டம்ஸையும், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் x and y, x and constant டம், then y and constant டம், இது ரெண்டையும் கம்பேர் பண்ணி x y ஸோட வேல்யூஸ் நம்ம ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். ஓகேவா, சம்ஸ் போடும்போது உங்களுக்கு ஈஸியா இருக்கும், சம்ஸ் பார்க்கலாம். ஓகே, that exercise number 3.13 first question. Okay, question number 1, exercise 3.13 question number 1. Okay, first question, first subdivision, 8x minus 3y is equal to 12, and another equation 5x is equal to 2y plus 7. Okay, So now you can take it. Already I told you the right hand side must be 0. So what we have to do? You can take the constants and any variables are there. You can take it to bring it to left hand side. So 8x minus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. Okay, this is equation number 1. Then another equation, 5x minus 2y minus 7 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Okay, then next step, what we have to do? This is our a1. 8 is the a1 and minus 3 is the b1 and minus 12 is the c1. Okay, this is our a1, this is our b1 and this is our c1. Okay, then this is our a2, this is our b2 and this is our c2. So what we have to do? First we can mention the variables, that is x and y and 1. Okay, then we can start from b1 b2. So what is our b1? Minus 3 and b2 is minus 2. Then what is our constant? c1 minus 12 and next minus 7. Then next a1 is plus 8 and here plus 5. Then next term again minus 3 minus 2. Okay, then do the cross multiplication. X divided by minus into minus plus, minus 3 into minus 7, minus into minus plus, so 3 sevens are 21. Then as per the formula minus, then 2 into 12, minus 2 and the minus 12, you will get plus 24. Okay, so this 24, then that is equal to y divided by, then 12 5s are minus 12 into 5, you will get minus 60. Then as per the formula minus, then here 8 sevens are 56, so minus 56, already minus is there, so plus 56. Okay, then that is equal to 1 divided by 8 2s are minus 16, then formula minus, 3 5s are 15, so minus 15, so minus into minus plus 15. Okay, so what do you get? X divided by 21 minus 24, you will get minus 3. Then y is equal to minus 60 plus 56, you will get minus 4. And 1 divided by minus 16 plus 15, you will get minus 1. Okay, so therefore x by minus 3 is equal to y by minus 4. And 1 by minus 1, you will get minus 1. Okay, then next you want to compare the x term and the constant term. Okay, so x by minus 3 is equal to minus 1. So what do you get? If you take cross multiply, x is equal to minus 3 into minus 1, you will get plus 3. So x is the value of plus 3. Then next, the same way, y divided by minus 4, that is equal to minus 1. Then again cross multiplication, so y is equal to minus 1 into minus 4, you will get plus 4. So the value of x and y is, x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4. Okay, therefore the value of x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 4. Okay, so your first problem over. In the first problem, first subdivision over. Okay, then second subdivision. Second subdivision, 6x plus 7y minus 11 is equal to 0. And another equation, 5x plus 2y is equal to 13. Already I told you the right hand side must be 0. So the first equation is already it is in the form, no problem. So you can take it as equation number 1. Then second equation you can change it. 5x plus 2y minus 13 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Then as usual, the same way, what we have to do? First you can take it as x and y, then constant term 1. So you can start from the second variable, y variable, you can choose it. Okay, what is that? 7 and second equation 2. Okay, then constant term minus 11, here minus 13. Then first x coefficients, that is 6, here 5. Okay, then again the y constants, y coefficients, that is 7 and 2. Okay, then do the cross multiplication. Okay, so what do you get? X divided by 7 into 13, you will get minus 91. Okay, then formula minus 2 into 11, 22. So minus 22, so it becomes plus 22. Okay, then that is equal to y divided by 11 into 5, so you will get minus 55. Then formula minus, then 6 into 13, you will get 78. So minus 78, it becomes plus 78. Okay, that is equal to 1 divided by 6 twos are 12, then minus 7 fives are 35. Okay, then x divided by minus 91 plus 22. If you can, if you subtract, you will get minus 69. Okay, then y divided by minus 55 plus 78, you will get plus 23. Okay, then that is equal to 1 divided by minus plus 12 minus 35, you will get minus 23. Okay, after that what you have to do? You should compare the constant term and the x term. So what is our x term? You can divide it into two parts. X divided by minus 69 is equal to 1 divided by minus 23. You can take it, this minus 69 to the right hand side. So x is equal to minus 69 divided by minus 23. Minus minus cancel. If you will cancel 23 by 69 by 23 means you will get 3 times. Okay, so therefore the x is equal to 3. Then another value, y divided by 23, should compare with the constant y, 1 by minus 23. Okay, so y is equal to, this you can take it right hand side, so 23 by minus 23. So 23 cancel, so it will get 1. Okay, so here in denominator we have a minus, so the y value is minus 1. Okay, therefore the value of x is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus 1. Okay, the second problem over, second subdivision is over. Then third question, first question, third subdivision. Third subdivision, the question is 2 by x plus 3 by y is equal to 5. Okay, then another equation, 3 by x minus 1 by y plus 9 is equal to 0. Okay, so already we did the same model. If the variables are in the denominator, means you should take it as the another variable. For example, let you can take it 1 by x is equal to a. Okay, let 1 by x is equal to a and 1 by y is equal to b. So what we have to do? You can take it as 2a. So 1 by x is a, so that is 2a plus 3b, then plus 5, it comes the left hand side, it will become minus 5. that is equal to 0. This is equation number 1. Okay, then another equation 3 by x. So you can take it as 3a, then minus b, then plus 9 is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Okay, then you can use the cross multiplication method. Okay, so what is that? So here we are taking the variable a. So here also you can take it a, b and 1. Okay, so first you can take the coefficients of b. What is that? 3 minus 1 and constant term minus 5 plus 9, and then coefficient of a is 2, 3 and again b constant coefficients 3 and minus 1. Okay, so what we have to do? You can do the cross multiplication. That is a divided by 3 9s are 27. Okay, so 27 minus minus 1 into minus 5, you will get plus 5. Then next one, b is equal to 5 3s are 15, so minus 15. Then formula minus 9 2s are 18, so minus 18. Okay, then next one, 1 divided by the constant 2 into minus 1, minus 2, then formula minus 3 3s are 9, so minus 9. Okay, then next, a divided by 27 minus 5, you will get 22. Then next one, b divided by minus 15 and minus 18, you will get minus 33. Then 1 divided by minus 7, because both also same sign. Same sign means you have to add. Okay, then you can compare the constant and the variable a. Okay, then next, you can take it two parts. That is a by 22, that is equal to 1 divided by minus 11. So a is equal to this 12, 22 becomes right hand side. Okay, so 22 by minus 11, so 2 times, so you will get a is equal to minus 2. This is a value only. Okay, but the question is in the x and y. Okay, so you should change the variables. Then next one, b by minus 33 is equal to 1 by minus 11, so b is equal to minus 33 by minus 11. Minus minus cancel, 11 33 means 3 times, so b is equal to 3. Okay, this is value of b. So we need the value of x and y. So we know that a is nothing but 1 by x. Okay, so what we have to do? If you want to find the x value, you can take it a reciprocal of a. So what is that? X is equal to minus 1 by 2. Then next one, b is equal to 3. So b is equal to 1 by y. So therefore, y is equal to, what is y value? B value is 3. B value is 3. So you can take the reciprocals. So that is 1 by 3. Okay. Therefore, the value of x is equal to minus 1 by 2 and y is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. So your first question, third solution over. Okay. Next, we are going to see the word problem. The second question is, Akshaya has 2 rupee coins and 5 rupee coins in her purse. Okay. If in all she has 80 coins, the total number of coins is 80. Okay. Then it is, the total amount is rupees 220. How many coins of each kind does she have? So, இரண்டு காயின்ஸ்லையும் எவ்வளோ தனித்தனியாக அவரோட கவுண்டிங் எவ்வளோ எத்தனை காயின்ஸ் இருக்கு அப்படிங்கிறத ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணும். ஓகே, ஸோ அக்ஷயோட பர்ஸில் 2 ருபி காயின், 5 ருபி காயின்ஸ் ரெண்டுமே இருக்கு. டோட்டல் நம்பர் ஆஃப் காயின்ஸ் 80, டோட்டல் அமௌண்ட் 220. ஸோ அப்போ ரெண்டு காயின்ஸ் எவ்வளோ இருக்கு அப்படிங்கிறத நம்ம ஃபைண்ட் அவுட் பண்ணணும். ஓகே, ஸோ த செகண்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ், let the number of 2 rupee coins, number of 2 rupee coins be x, okay, and number of 5 rupee coins, 5 rupee coins be y, okay. So what is the condition? By the given first condition, by the given first condition, according to the first condition, we are taking the number of coins must be x and y, okay. So the total number of coins is 80. So what we have to do, that is x plus y is equal to 80, okay. So what we can do, we can take it as x plus y minus 80 equal to 0. This is equation number 1, okay. Then second condition, by the second condition, by the second condition, the amount, okay, wow. So amount ங்கும் போது என்ன பண்ணுவோம், 2 rupee coins ல எவ்வளவு amount இருக்கு அப்படின்னா என்ன பண்ணுவோம், 2 into the number of coins, so you can take it as 2x, okay, wow. ஏன்னா xங்கிறது 2 rupee coins எடுத்துருக்கோம், number of coins x, so 2 rupees ங்கும் போது நீ 2 ஆல மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணிக்கணும், then 5 rupee coins னா 5 ஆல மல்டிப்ளை பண்ணிக்கீங்க, so 5y, 5y is equal to what, rupees 220, so 5x, sorry, 2x plus 5y is equal to 220, so you can take it as the usual form, that is 2x plus 5y minus 220, this is equal to 0, this is second equation, okay. Then after that, the same method, what we have to do, the cross multiplication, you can take the x variable and y variable, then constant term. What is our first equation, x plus y minus 80, okay. So you can start from the coefficient of y, okay. So that is 1, here 5, okay. The first equation x plus y, okay. So x plus y minus 80, here 2x plus 5y minus 220. So you can take it as 1, 5, then y constants, y coefficient is, sorry, the constant term is minus 80, here minus 220, okay. Then next, coefficient of x is 1 and 2, then again the coefficient of y, that is 1 and 5, okay. So next you can do the cross multiplication, so x divided by 1 into minus 220, you will get minus 220, then formula minus 5 into 80, 400, so plus 400, okay. Then that is equal to y divided by 2 into minus 80, you will get minus 160, then formula minus 1 into minus 220, minus 220, so already you have a minus, so it will become plus, okay, so 220. Then the constant term, 1 divided by 5 minus 2, okay. So what do you get, x divided by minus 220 plus 400, so you will get plus 180 is equal to y divided by minus 160 plus 220, you will get plus 60, then 1 divided by 5 minus 2, you will get 3, okay. Then next we can compare the x variable and the constant term. So x by 180 is equal to 1 by 3. So x is equal to 180 by 3. So if you cancel, you will get 60, okay. So x is equal to 60. So what is x? Our number of 2 rupee coins, okay. Then y divided by 60 is equal to 1 by 3. So you can take cross multiplication. So y is equal to 60 by 3. So you will get cancel. So 3 3 into 20 60. So y value is 20. Therefore, after that you should write the sentences. Okay, number of x is the number of 2 rupee coins. So number of 2 rupee coins is equal to 60, and number of 5 rupee coins is equal to 20. Okay, this is your answer. Then third question, it takes 24 hours to fill a swimming pool using 2 pipes. If the pipe of larger diameter is used for 8 hours and the pipe of smaller diameter is used for 18 hours, only half of the pool is filled. Okay, how long would each pipe take to fill the swimming pool? என்ன சொல்லிருக்காங்க அப்படின்னா, ஒரு ஸ்விம்மிங் பூல் இருக்கு, அதுல வந்து ரெண்டு பைப்பை வச்சு என்ன பண்றாங்க, வாட்டர் ஃபில் பண்றாங்க. ஓகேவா? சோ அது ஃபில் ஆகுறதுக்கு எவ்வளவு டைம் எடுக்குது? ரெண்டு பைப்பையும் சேர்ந்து ஃபில் பண்ணாங்க அப்படின்னா 24 ஹவர்ஸ் டைம் எடுக்குது. ஓகேவா? தென் இது ஒரு கண்டிஷன். அனதர் கண்டிஷன் என்ன சொல்லியிருக்காங்க, லார்ஜ் டைமீட்டர் உள்ள இதுல ஃபில் பண்ணோம் அப்படின்னா 8 ஹவர்ஸும், ஸ்மாலர் டைமீட்டர் இதுல உள்ளதுல ஃபில் பண்ணா 18 ஹவர்ஸும் ஆகுது. அப்ப வந்து என்ன ஆகுது, ஒன்லி ஹாஃப் ஆஃப் த பூல் தான் ஃபில் ஆகுது. அப்படி பண்ணும்போது, தனித்தனியா பண்ணும்போது. ஓகே, சோ ஹவ் லாங் வுட் ஈச் பைப் டேக் டு ஃபில் தி ஸ்விமிங் பூல். சோ அப்போ ஃபுல்லா ஃபில் பண்றதுக்கு எவ்வளவு டைம் எடுக்கும் ரெண்டுத்துக்கும் அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டு கேக்குறாங்க. சரியா? சோ கவனிங்க, லெட் த டைம், திஸ் இஸ் அ பிக் ப்ராப்ளம். ஓகே, சோ யூ கேன் லிசன் கேர்ஃபுல்லி. டைம் டேக்கன் by larger diameter, larger diameter larger diameter pipe. Okay, so பெரிய pipe diameter இருக்கிற பைப்ல ஃபில் ஆகுறதுக்கான டைம் வந்து எக்ஸ்னு எடுத்துக்கணும். ஓகேவா? தென் எக்ஸ் ஆஸ். ஓகே, தென் அண்ட் த டைம் டேக்கன் அண்ட் த டைம் டேக்கன் பை த ஸ்மாலர் டயமீட்டர் பைப் smaller diameter pipe b y has. okay, va so சின்ன பைப்ல உள்ளத y has எடுத்துக்கோ. okay, y has. the sentence also you should write in your notebook. okay, then so according to the first condition, what is the condition? If you are using the two pipes, the time taken is 24 hours. ஓகேவா? சோ அப்ப ரெண்டு பைப்லையும் சேர்ந்து ஃபில் பண்ணும்போது நமக்கு 24 hours ஆகுதுன்னு சொல்லியிருக்காங்க. அப்ப என்ன பண்ணிக்கலாம், கண்டிஷன் படி சோ அப்ப வந்து டைம் எடுக்கும்போது நீங்க என்ன பண்ணணும் அப்படின்னா ரிவர்ஸ்ல எடுக்கணும். சோ அப்ப எக்ஸ் ஹார்ஸ் இப்ப ரெண்டு பைப்லையும் சேர்ந்து நம்ம ஃபில் பண்ணும்போது 24 hours ஆகுது. அப்ப 1 ஹவருக்கு வந்து அந்த டேங்க் எவ்வளவு ஃபில் ஆகும் அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி எடுத்துக்கணும். சோ யூ கேன் டேக் இட் அஸ் 1/x plus 1/y is equal to 1/24. புரியுதா? சோ நமக்கு டைம் வந்து டோட்டலா 24 ஹவர்ஸ் ஆகுது. அப்போ 1 ஹவர்ல எவ்வளவு ஆகும் அப்படிங்கிற மாதிரி நம்ம கன்சிடர் பண்ணிக்கணும். அப்போ 1/x plus 1/y is equal to 1/24. This is equation number 1. Okay, then next one. Also another condition is what pa? Also in 8 hours the larger pipe, 8 hours ல ஃபில் ஆகுது அப்படின்னா, also in 8 hours the larger pipe the large pipe fill. So 8 hours ங்கும் போது நீங்க 8 ஆல மல்டிபிள் பண்ணிக்கிங்க. So you can take it as 8 by x. Okay. Then eight by x. Okay. For the smaller pipe, it will take 18 hours. So you can take it as in 18 hours, the smaller pipe. Okay. The smaller pipe fill. Okay. So you can take it as 18 by y. So when the 8 hours or 18 hours fill up, the half of the tank will fill up. So what we have to do? 8 by x according to the condition, 8 by x plus 18 by y is equal to half of the tank. So you can take it as 1 by 2. Okay, this is equation number 2. Okay, then we have an equation 1 by x plus 1 by y is equal to 1 by 24, and 8 by x plus 18 by y is equal to 1 by 2. So what we have to do? The variables are in the denominator, so you can take it as 1 by x, let 1 by x is equal to a and 1 by y is equal to b. Okay, so the first equation, it's changed to, what is that? A plus b is equal to 1 by 24. Okay, so in this right hand side, we have a denominator 24. So we can multiply by 24. So what do you get? 24a plus 24b is equal to 1. Okay, so we can take it as 24a plus 24b minus 1 is equal to 0. This is equation number 3. Then another equation, the second equation, if you are substituting 1 by x is equal to a and 1 by y is equal to b in the second equation, means you will get 8 by x, huh? So you can take it as 8a. Okay, the second equation is changed into 8a plus 18b is equal to 1 by 2. 18b is equal to 1 by 2. So here we have a denominator 2, so you can multiply by 2. So what do you get? 16a plus 36b is equal to 1. So next it will change it into 16a 36b minus 1 is equal to 0. This is equation number 4. Okay, then as usual, the cross multiplication method. Okay, so what is that? A b 1. Okay, so you start from the coefficient of b. What is our coefficient? Here 24, here 36. So here you can take it as 24, 36, then the constant term is both also minus 1. So minus 1, minus 1. Then next, the coefficient of a. Coefficient of a is 24 and 16. Then again the first two terms, that is 24 and 31. Okay. Then next you can do the cross multiplication. Okay. That is a by 1 into 24, 24, so minus 24, formula minus 1 into 31, 31, so plus 31, that is equal to b divided by 1 into 16, so you will get minus 16, then formula minus 1 into 24, 24, so plus 24, then is equal to 1 divided by 24 into 31, you will get 864. Okay, then formula minus 16 into 24, you will get 384. Okay, so the next term, a divided by minus 24 plus 31, you will get 7. Okay, sorry, 24 here you will get 36. Okay, here you will get 36. Okay, so therefore here also you will get 36. I think that's all. here also 36. Okay. So 24 into 36 and 16 into 24. Okay. So what is that? So 24 minus 24 plus 36, you will get A divided by minus 24 plus 36, you will get 12. Then B divided by minus 16 plus 24, you will get 8. And 1 divided by 864 minus 384, you will get 480. Okay. Then you should compare the A constant with the constant term. Okay. That is A by 12 is equal to 1 by 480. Okay. So what do you get? A is equal to 12 divided by 480. So it will be cancelled. So 4 times are so 40. So A is equal to 1 by 40. Okay. Then next, B by 8 is equal to 1 by 480. So B is equal to 8 by 480. For 6 times, so you will get 8 into 480, 60. Okay. So B is equal to 1 by 60. This is B value. But we need what? X and Y. So what we have to do? You can take it as reciprocals. So therefore, already we took A is equal to 1 by X. Okay. Therefore, X is equal to 1 by A. That implies X is equal to 40. Okay. Then the same way, B is equal to 1 by Y. That implies Y is equal to 1 by B. So you can take it reciprocals. So Y is equal to 1 by 60, it becomes 60. Okay, wow. So this is the total hours. But we need only the half of the tank. No. Already half of the tank fill aayiruchi. So irukkira vela idu vandu total time da. Larger pipe fill aagradhukana total time and smaller pipe fill aagradhukana total time. So we need to find only half of the pool is filled. So remaining half of the pool we want to fill. So you can take it the half of the value. Therefore, to fill the remaining half of the pool. Okay. So remaining half of the pool. So time taken by larger pipe. Okay. Larger pipe la namakku seekiram fill aayirum. So appo vandu evlo time eduthirukku anga 40 hours eduthirukku. So appo adula half moombodhu half into 40, so you will get 20 hours. Okay. Then smaller pipe la fill aagumbodhu namakku enna aagum time vandu inna konjam adhigama irukum. So time taken by smaller pipe okay, that is 1 by 2 into 60. So if you cancel, you will get 30. Therefore, this is what 30 years. Okay. So in sum, konjam periya sum da, konjam podumbodhu careful ah podunga. Okay. Thank you, students.